Session state and sessions are using in ASP.NET web application development. It's a state management technique, one of the state management technique where we have to know about how to use sessions, the user sessions, application level session, different sessions we can create while developing the application based on our requirement. Simple technique, when once we if we used the session, whenever we used and utilized, we exiting from that particular user or session from there, we need to terminate that particular session or we need to empty the session to close. Hence, we can give in a good productivity on performance of the application as well as scalability will not be give us any negative performance. See, it uses when you are storing short-lived information that is specific to an individual session data. If I am logged in using my username and password, I'm there as a developer, I'm creating user-specific session to store the username or email ID, wherever some parameters specifically the required of the user from the user, I can store at the user level session. For the session, if I the user is moved from one page to another page, the session will be carried forward the entire the user where he has a round trips of the server, round trips and forms which is accessible to him. That entire pages where that parameter of the session initiated parameter I can use. And not recommended to store large amount of the data in the session state. Strongly remember. To be clear that on every session state object will be created and maintained for the lifetime of every session of your application after using the session to be terminate perfectly. Many developers use it to create sessions and not closing properly. It may occupy the significant server resources and affect the scalability and the performance of the web application. You strongly aware of that if you are used by logging in. And if it is not, if the user is logged out, there you are clearly mentioning that the user is logged out. There you need to write session termination and close the sessions if you are used likewise any parameters. Why? If you are created a session in the on the server side, the session will occupy some of the space and initiating and carry forward. It's the state management technique from the server side. And it will occupy the server sessions and many of the users log in and using your application. And that many of the sessions will create on the server side and using the occupying the memory and cache and all. Likewise, you strongly remember that. In the real-time example, we will see how to initiate the session level parameter and how to use the parameter with the using of the session name only. See, we will see here in ASP.NET, it's a very simple and easy technique to initiating and handling the fun with the session parameters. Like on page load or wherever you are loading the parameters and there you can initiate simply like a session of the name which is the parameter name you are going to storing here, informative ID you need to a name and create that ID to identify wherever you require to use the session name, session parameter. If ID, name, nomenclature is very important to identify and remember, memorized the things of the session parameters and username I am passing to this parameter. That's it. I am getting the parameter from the database and I am pushing into the session name wherever I require to enter the application of moving the parameter one form to another form of the round trip of the user. And whenever some other form I want to use username, what is the username I am going to submitting some data, which user is submitted this particular data. Hence I require the username or user unique ID or user identity I require to save on the database to pass the parameter. I'll straight away use this session parameter and so to send to the database to that parameter and I'll save it for my database records when it is happened, the date of the parameter that transaction is happened. Such data, if I want to pass, I'll use simply session name like this. You see that using session parameters, how it is. session name, the same thing is common, session name with the respective of ID, and dot to string and terminate line. Wherever the parameter we are mapping to something like a string, username and all, we will call it as the parameter. As you know, that dot to string or dot to int and conversion, if it is there, any int to conversions are there, we will see while handling the data types. Likewise, and also you will learn the C# tutorial to know much more about these all the things. And here, that session name, the name of the ID we are calling, which parameter we need to map to username. I have a sent a data into the session parameter called a name. Hence, I am using the name parameter here, and a string. I have taken this form as the username as a parameter. I want to map this parameter as a username wherever required in the form. If I am passing registration ID, like registration ID, I am also says that reg ID, and here I'll tell that reg ID, and this is the parameter name is reg ID. If any casting and conversion data types, if it is there, I will use it. If it is string, yes, varchar character. If it is string only, I'll straight away use this. Or else if it is an int, I'll go with the respect repeated with the int and the parameter name I have mentioned here. And here I will tell that convert dot 2 int 32 or respective data type, and here I'll make it as a mention of this one to make it move into end of the brace, and it will be converted to the int parameter. Likewise, type of conversations and all the things you have to aware and know. If you are not aware of the conversations and all, you go into the basics with the C# language once, and you will be know about the standards and the conversions and the data types thoroughly, and it will be easy to handle parameters, which parameter is which data type and how it I can be converted and to move use handling with the parameters very easy manner. Come to the session initiation of the session. This is the way where we need to initiate the session simply, and using of the parameter session. That's it. You need not to write the query parameter sending and passing the parameter something how it is. You will try to use it. Someone, the logged in page or home page, I have created this one. Some other page, some lost page or contact page or submit page, any form of the year, you can straight away write this session and use the parameter. That session parameter will come and map to this ID. That is the way, the pipeline session means the pipeline of the entire role of the parameters of the forms. It is mapped like a form, and it can be used, access and use that parameter easily. And also you can verify that session if the session parameter is valid, the data is available or not. If not, you pull that message to user and re-login. Maybe some session expires are there and all. To handle if conditions, you may use or you properly use any validation controls also. I hope you better understand and know about the session state management technique using in ASP.NET web application development. Hope you better understand. If any clarifications, you may comment us and write us at Hari Systems. We'll definitely keep in touch with you for give you a good ideology about it in more details if required. Hope you understand. Thank you for watching this session. Thank you.